Elhamdülillah Rabbil Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Elhamdülillahi Rabbil Alemin. Ve salatu ve selamu ala Resulina ve Habibina ve tabi kulubina Muhammedin ve ala alihi ve sahbihi ecma'in. Radıyallahu anna ve anki ve anki afetil müminin. Rabbena atina min ledunke rahmeten ve hiyyik lana min emrina raşada. Sümme el murid el mutecerrid lizzikri vel fikri قد تقطعه قواطع كثيرة. So Imam Ghazali explained that the murid, the one who uses his will, you know, to purify his heart and surrender completely to the will of Allah Ta'ala and oppose to the will of the nafs and the hedonistic self, while he's going through these processes, he faces some risks, and that those risks may stop his spiritual progress. Those risks, they are called kawati'. Kawati' comes from kati', kawati'. It means those things that cut the path or the road of a traveler, that stops him from continuing his journey. So thumma al murid al mutajarrid, the murid who exclusively concentrates li dhikr wal fikr, you know, to make zikr and to make a contemplation, but taqta'uhu qawat al kathira, you know, he may be stopped, he may be held back by many, many risks and obstacles. What are those obstacles that may stop his progress, spiritual progress? Min al-ujub. One of them is ujub. Ujub means secret self-love or secret arrogance. Yani al-kibr al-khafi. There is kibr, which is open, and there is hidden kibr. Hidden arrogance. So people act outside, externally. They present themselves as if they are very humble. But inside their heart, they think, you know, they are very important people and they are above their friends and people around them. So this is kind of secret arrogance. And this is called ujub. For instance, sometimes like you meet people, they say, I'm not at the level of people around me. I am higher, much superior than them, by I act in a humble way. You know, and I, you know, this is riya, this pretension. It's not real humility. Real humility, when you think you are really below the level of other people. It is not humility if you think inside of your heart that you are superior or better than other people, but you are pretending, you know, acting outwardly as if you are humble. So this is called riya ut-tawadu', you know, pretending as if you are humble. So that's al-ujub. So the ujub is one of the inflictions that may occur during riyada when the murid is making zikr and fikr. So inside of his heart, he may think, oh, I am really important man. See, I am making riyada. I am making all this zikr and fikr. I am better than people outside. So, and then his journey stops. Because of this kind of wrong thinking, okay? Riya, the other one is riya, you know, showing off. So when you are in seclusion, making riyada, making all the zikr and fikr, you know, nafs and shaitan may tell you, why don't you let other people know that, you know, you are going through all these, you know, sacred actions and processes. والفرح بما ينكشف له من الأحوال and also you know being carried on being too happy you know with the spiritual states you know he's going through too much happiness you know with the progress he's making in his spiritual journey and attributing these things to his success not attributing them to the gift of Allah Ta'ala you know so any progress one makes you know should attribute it to the generosity of Allah Ta'ala to the to the gifts of Allah Ta'ala not to himself to his own work or success it's a grace from Allah Ta'ala that you know this divine grace makes him you know make progress وَمَا يَبْدُو مِنْ أَوَائِلِ الْكَرَامَاتِ and also he may be too happy with the you know primary karamat he may experience some extraordinary things that's happening through him وَمَهْمَا إِلْتَفَتَ إِلَى شَيْءٍ مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَشَغَلَ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ كَانَ ذَلِكَ فُتُورًا فِي طَرِيقِهِ أَوْ وُقُوفًا So if ever, you know, he pays attention to these things, like أوائل الكرامات and أحوال وَشَغَلَ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ and starts thinking, you know, about these things, كَانَ ذَلِكَ فُتُورًا فِي طَرِيقِهِ أَوْ وُقُوفًا So this kind of distraction, you know, focusing on the states and those karamas rather than the journey itself and how one can make further progress, this would be distraction. And also weakness. Futur means weakness, distraction, losing concentration on the path. Or complete halt, you know, complete stop, because the concentration should be 100% completely on the journey, not on the states or karamat or other things. بل ينبغي أن يلازم حاله جملة عمره ملازمة العطشان الذي لا ترويه البحار ولو أفيضت عليه. So he should stick all the time, you know, all his life, you know, about his own state and how to move forward, similar to a thirsty person, who does not quench. Even if he drinks the sea, you know, the sea, even if the sea is, you know, given to him and he drinks the whole sea, doesn't get, you know, satisfied. You know, his thirst is not gone. So, you know, one should always be like this for his whole life, you know, always hungry, always thirsty for more spiritual progress. ويدوم على ذلك. He should continue all the time like this. ورأس ماله الانقطاع عن الخلق إلى الحق والخلوة. His capital is seclusion from the creation and turning to Allah Ta'ala and also الخلوة. You know, withdrawal, solitude. But once this in this ra'sul mal, this capital, is lost, because one gets distracted with other things, that he experiences, then the journey stops. وقال بعض السياحين, some of the travelers, they said that قلت لبعض الأبدال المنقطعين عن الخلق كيف الطريق إلى التحقيق. So some of the saints, al-abdal means saints, you know, but these saints, they are called abdal because when one dies, a replacement comes to his place. You know, it comes from badal, badal, you know, and badal means replacement. So, you know, they are replacing saints. You know, when one dies, the other you know, is appointed by Allah Ta'ala to take his place and carry on the work the previous one has been doing. That's why they are called abdal. So one of those abdal, al-munqati'ina an al-khalq, the one who's disconnected from the creation in his heart. So al-munqati' an al-khalq means he is cut off from the creation. That means he is not attached to the creation. He is attached to Allah Ta'ala, not to the creation. His attachment to creation is cut off, and his complete love and attention is directed to Allah Ta'ala. So such a person was asked, كيف الطريق إلى التحقيق? You know, what's the way to reach to تحقيق, to the level of verification, to the level of reaching the way to reach to حق اليقين, حق اليقين, this experiential knowledge, which brings complete certainty, yaqeen. So فقال أن تكون في الدنيا كأنك عابر طريق. So that Abdal, this person from Abdal, he said that the path or the method to reach to التحقيق is that you live in the world as if you are a traveler. وقال مرة, and he also said on another occasion, قلت له, I asked him, دلني على عمل أعمله أجد فيه قلبي مع الله تعالى على الدوام. You know, so this traveler asked this person from the Abdal, show me a practice. When I do it, I find my heart continuously with Allah Ta'ala. So always making zikr of Allah Ta'ala and away from the ghaflet. فَقَالَ لِي, that saint told me, لَا تَنْزُرْ إِلَى الْخَلْقِ. You know, don't pay attention to the creation. Don't pay attention to people. فَإِنَّ النَّظَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ ظُلْمَةٌ. Because paying attention to the creation, to people, brings darkness to your heart. قُلْتُ لَا بُدَّ لِي مِنْ ذَلِكَ. I responded to him and said that you know, paying attention to people is necessary for me. I cannot dispense with it. قال فلا تسمع كلامهم فإن كلامهم قسوة. Then he said, okay, if you cannot do this, then don't listen to their talks. Because their talks brings hardness to the heart. It makes your heart hard, hardened, kaswa, you know. Kuntu la budda li min thalike. I told him, it is necessary for me to listen to the speeches of people. I cannot, you know, leave it. Qala fala tu'amilhum fa inna mu'amalatahum wahshatun. And he said, then don't interact with them, because interacting with them brings wildness to your heart. Wahshat means loneliness, and wildness. So, but here, wahshat means gaflet. Gaflet, you know, wahshat from Allah Ta'ala. You know, kultu ana bayna azhurihim. And I told him, I am always among them. La budda li min mu'amalatihim. You know, it is necessary that I interact with them. Qala fala taskun ilayhim. And he said, don't settle down with them. فَإِنَّ السُّكُونَ إِلَيْهِمْ هَلَكَةٌ. Because settling down with them causes destruction. You know, قُلْتُ هَذِهِ الْعِلَّةُ. And I told him, is this the cause of destruction, or is this the illness? فَقَالَ يَا هَذَا, O my friend, أَتَنْزُرُ إِلَى الْغَافِلِينَ وَتَسْمَعُ كَلَامَهُمْ وَتَسْمَعُ كَلَامَ الْجَاهِلِينَ وَتُعَامِلُ الْبَطَّالِينَ وَتُرِيدُ أَنْ تَجِدَ قَلْبَكَ. Move up a little bit, please. Kayim Uja, yes, okay. All right. okay. No. Let's go to the previous page. Okay. Move down a little bit. Okay. Tamam. So this saint said that, أَتَنْزُرُ إِلَى الْأَغَافِلِينَ. You know, are you looking at the heedless people, you know, who forget Allah Ta'ala, al-ghafirin, وَتَسْمَعُ كَلَامَ الْجَاهِلِينَ, and you are hearing the speech of the ignorant people, وَتُعَامِلُ بَطَّالِينَ, and you are interacting with lazy people, وَتُرِيدُ أَن تَجْدَ قَلْبَكَ مَعَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَ عَلَى الدَّوَامِ, and you want your heart to be constantly with Allah Ta'ala, you know, you want your heart to constantly make zikr of Allah Ta'ala, هذا ما لا يكون أبدا. This is impossible. You know, this is never going to take place. So, you know, one has to leave these things so that, you know, his heart can be with Allah Ta'ala all the time. So these are قواطع. قواطع, you know, the things that hold people from making spiritual progress to reach to the state of constant zikr of Allah Ta'ala, and also doing everything for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. Yes. فَإِذَاً, if this is so, مُنْتَهَ الرِّيَاضَةِ أَنْ يَجِدَ قَلْبَهُ مَعَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَلَى الدَّوَامِ. So the goal, or the last stage of al-riyada is that one finds his heart all the time with Allah Ta'ala. That's the goal of riyada. That's the end of riyada, that your heart is always with Allah Ta'ala, and you are never in ghaflet with Allah Ta'ala. ولا يمكن ذلك إلا بأن يخلو عن غيره. This is not possible except by abandoning things other than him. ولا يخلو عن غيره إلا بطول المجاهدة. But this kind of abandoning other things other than Allah Ta'ala, is not easily possible. It is possible only through a long inner struggle. You know, a long inner struggle. This is called mujahada. فَإِذَا حَصَلَ قَلْبُهُ مَعَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ إِنْكَشَفَ لَهُ جَلَالُ الْحَضْرَةِ الرُّبُوبِيَّةِ وَتَجَلَّى لَهُ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَرَ لَهُ مِنْ لَطَائِفِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ مَا لَا يَجُوزُ أَنْ يُوصَفَ بَلْ لَا يُحِيطُ بِهِ الْوَصْفُ أَصْلًا. So, فَإِذَا حَصَلَ قَلْبُهُ مَعَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ, when he reaches to this station, and his heart becomes constantly with Allah Ta'ala. In kashafa lahu jalal al-hadrat al-rububiyyati, the glory of the Lord becomes explicit, you know, visible, open to him. Wa tajalla lahu al-haqqu, truth becomes explicit, manifest, clear for him. Wa zahara lahu min lata'ifi Allah Ta'ala, it becomes apparent for him the subtle gifts of Allah Ta'ala, the subtle gifts and the subtle knowledge of Allah Ta'ala becomes explicit and apparent for him. Ma la yajuzu an yusaf, but it is not permissible to describe them. Bal la yuhitu bihi al-wasf aslan, and actually they are ineffable. You know, the description cannot cover it. You know, a description is powerless. You know, they are beyond any description. So even you know, first, you know, it's not permissible to describe them. Second, even if you want to describe them, you cannot describe them. You know, they are ineffable. They cannot be described. وَإِذَا كَشَفَ لِلْمُرِيدِ شَيْءٌ مِّن ذَلِكَ, when something like this becomes manifest for the students, فَعَزَمَ الْقَوَاتِ عَلَيْهِ أَن يَتَكَلَّمَ بِهِ وَعْزًا وَنُصْحًا, the biggest risk that may stop him is to talk about his own experience, to preach to other people, and to give them advice. So the biggest risk is to use your own experience, you know, by disclosing them, to give, you know, nasihat, you know, advice and guidance to other people. You know, وَيَتَصَدَّى لِلْتَذْكِيرِ, also taking up, you know, teaching to other people. فَتَجِدُ النَّفْسُ فِيهِ لَدَّةً لَيْسَ وَرَاءَهَا لَزَّةٌ, and the nafs finds a big pleasure in teaching to other people, you know, trying to educate them. This is such a big pleasure, no other pleasure can be bigger than this pleasure of putting yourself, you know, in the position of a teacher and teaching to other people. فَتَدْعُوهُ تِلْكَ اللَّزَّةُ إِلَىٰ إِنْ يَتَفَكَّرَ فِي كَيْفِيَّةِ إِرَادِ تِلْكَ الْمَعَانِي وَتَحْسِينِ الْأَلْفَاظِ الْمُعَبِّرَةِ عَنْهَا وَتَرْتِيبِ ذِكْرِهَا وَتَزِيِّنِهَا بِالْحِكَايَاتِ وَشَوَاهِدِ الْقُرْآنِ وَالْأَخْبَارِ وَتَحْسِينِ صِيغَةِ الْكَلَامِ. So his desire to educate other people, to teach other people, which gives him great pleasure, provokes him, or, you know, calls him to think about how to present these meanings to people, to the students, to the disciples. وتحسين الألفاظ المعبرة عنها, and also how to make nice speech, how to make the speech nicer, you know, when one expresses these meanings. وترتيب ذيك, how to organize them. وتزينها بالحكايات وشواهد القرآن والأخبار, and making the speech beautiful by using stories and also evidence from the Quran and also from the sayings of the previous generations. وتحسين صيغة الكلام, and also making the form of the speech nicer. So one starts thinking about these things after he self-appoints himself to the position of teaching to other people. لِتَمِيلَ إِلَيْهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَسْمَعَ to attract the hearts of other people and the ears of other people, you know, to what he's saying. وَالشَّيْطَانُ يُقْبَمَا يُخَيِّلُ إِلَيْهِ أَنَّ هَذَا إِحْيَاءٌ مِّنْكَ لِقُلُوبِ الْمَوْتَ الْغَافِلِينَ عَنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى and the shaitan makes him imagine about himself that what you are doing is, you know, reviving the dead hearts of the heedless people, you know, from Allah Ta'ala. وَإِنَّمَا أَنْتَ وَاسْطَةٌ بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَبَيْنَ الْخَلْقِ You are a mediator between the people and Allah Ta'ala. تَدْعُ عِبَادَهُ إِلَيْهِ You are inviting, you are calling his servants to Allah Ta'ala. وَمَا لَكَ فِيهِ نَصِيبٌ وَلَا لِنَفْسِكَ فِيهِ لَزَّةٌ And you have no share in this. Simply Allah is using you, you know, to call people himself and you don't get any pleasure from this. So this is how, you know, shaitan eludes him, you know, so he has this self-illusion that he's doing this because Allah appointed him to do that. But in fact, he's doing it because he gets some pleasure from it. So this is a big risk on the path. أهم القواطع. So if he starts doing this, then his spiritual journey will stop. ويتضح كيد الشيطان بأن يظهر في أقرانه من يكون أحسن كلاما منه وأجزل لفظا وأقدر على استجلاب قلوب العوام. And the trick of the shaitan becomes clear when another person among his friends, among his peers, emerges, but he speaks better, you know, and his speech is more fluent, and he's more powerful in attracting the hearts of the common people. When such a person emerges, then the trick of shaitan becomes clear. فَإِنَّهُ يَتَحَرَّكُ فِي بَاطِنِهِ أَقْرَبُ الْحَسَدِ Then in his heart, the scorpion of jealousy starts moving without any doubt. إِنْ كَانَ مُحَرِّكُهُ لَذَّةُ الْقَبُولِ You know, if he was motivated in his teaching, in his speeches, in his lectures, by the pleasure of popularity, by the pleasure of getting accepted by the common people. So if this is what motivated him in teaching other people, when he sees there is somebody else, he teaches better, he speaks better, he attracts more crowd to himself, then he becomes jealous of that person, you know, who gives more eloquent speeches than him. وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحَرِّكُهُ وَالْحَقَّ حِرْسًا عَلَى دَعْوَةِ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ فَيَعْزُمُ بِهِ فَرَحُهُ But if his motivation in teaching other people was his eagerness to really call people to Allah Ta'ala, to the right path, then he becomes more happy that, good, there is somebody else who is also doing the same thing I am doing for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. Instead of becoming jealous of that person, he becomes happy by the work of that person, you know, because he's sincere. I mean, his goal is to teach people religion and to call them to the right path. And there is another one who's doing the same thing better than himself. He becomes very happy with this. You know, وَيَكُولُ And he says, الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي عَضَدَنِي وَأَيَّدَنِي بِمَنْ وَازَرَنِي عَلَى إِصْلَاحِ عِبَادِهِ الحمد لله, Allah Ta'ala supports me with someone else in, teaching and educating the servants of Allah. You know, Allah sent me a support. You know, another person who's trying to do the same thing. This is a great support from Allah Ta'ala. So he becomes very happy with this. And thanks to Allah Ta'ala, كَالَّذِي وَجَبَ عَلَيْهِ مَثَلًا أَنْ يَحْمِلَ مَيِّتًا لِيُدْفِنَهُ إِذْ وَجَدَهُ ضَائِعًا وَتَعَيَّنَ عَلَيْهِ ذَلِكَ شَرْعًا فَجَاءَ مَنْ أَعَانَهُ عَلَيْهِ فَإِنَّهُ يَفْرَحُ بِهِ وَلَا يَحْسُدُ مُعِينَهُ. So Imam Ghazali said this is comparable, you know, to someone who's supposed to bury the dead body of a human being. And he needs somebody to help him, because there is this dead body, you know, he needs to have somebody to help him to bury that person. Then suddenly someone else comes. Then he becomes very happy, you know, that Allah sent a support so that he can fulfill his religious duty of burying this person. And he thanks to Allah Ta'ala that, you know, Allah sent support, help to him. So he doesn't become jealous of that person. You know, he becomes happy that, you know, this new person is helping him to fulfill his religious duty. Yes, well, غَافِلُونَ مَوْتَ الْقُلُوبِ, but the heedless people, you know, their hearts are dead. وَالْوَعَازِ هُمْ الْمُنَبِّهُونَ وَالْمُحْيُونَ لَهُمْ, and the preachers, they are the ones who wake them up, who resurrect their hearts. فَفِي كَثْرَتِهِمْ إِسْتِرْوَاحٌ وَتَنَاصُرٌ. So if there are more preachers, you know, more scholars to teach the common people, the ordinary people, you know, this makes life easier for you. You know, and there becomes solidarity among them. So you should be happy with this rather than being jealous. فَيَنْبَغِي أَنْ يَعْزُمَ الْفَرْحِ بِذَلِكَ. So that's why, you know, your happiness should increase, because there is somebody else who's trying to help you in doing the job. وَهَذَا عَزِيزُ الْوُجُودِ جِدًّا. But this is very rare. Unfortunately, this is very rare. You know, if there is a scholar, you know, who is trying to support and educate the people, and then there is somebody else, you know, doing this something, competition begins between them, and jealousy in their heart, the akrab al-hasad, the scorpion of jealousy, you know, starts moving in their hearts. That's why it's very rare, says Imam Ghazali. فَيَنْبَغِي أَنْ يَكُونَ الْمُرِيدُ عَلَى حَذَرٍ مِّنْهُ. So that's why the murid should be watching out that kind of risk and danger. فَإِنَّهُ أَعْزَمُ حَبَائِلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فِي قَطْعِ الطَّرِيقِ. So because this is one of the most effective hooks used by shaitan to stop people's spiritual progress. عَلَى مَنِنْ فَتَحَتْ لَهُ أَوَائِلُ الطَّرِيقِ. You know, in particular, you know, those people, you know, for whom the beginning of the path, the spiritual path, has been opened. So, you know, so one makes a little bit progress and suddenly starts thinking about how to teach to other people. You know, so wait until you complete your spiritual journey and your sheikh appoints you, tells you to teach other people. You know, don't self-appoint yourself to teach to other people when you are still in the beginning of the road. فإن إثارة الحياة الدنيا طبع غالب على الإنسان. This is because you know, giving priority, preference, top preference to the mundane life is the predominant feature of human beings. So this is already there, and a little bit inclination into that direction drags you to this point. وَلِذَٰلِكَ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ. This is the reason why Allah Ta'ala said, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. You give priority to the mundane world. You know, you prefer mundane world or other things. ثُمَّ بَيَّنَ أَنَّ الشَّرَّ قَدِيمٌ فِي التَّبَاعِ. And Allah Ta'ala also explicitly stated that evil is old, you know, in human nature. وَأَنَّ ذَلِكَ مَذْكُورٌ فِي الْكُتُبِ السَّالِفَةِ. And this is also mentioned in the previous sacred books, in the previous scriptures. فَقَالَ تَعَالَىٰ. And Allah says, إِنَّ هَذَا لَفِي السُّحُفِ الْأُولَىٰ. You know, that human beings, you know, give priority or preference to the mundane pleasures, mundane life. This is mentioned in the earlier scriptures, Suhuf Ibrahim and Musa, such as the scripture, you know, given to Ibrahim alayhi salam and Musa alayhi salam. So it's not something new. This is old, and it was always there in history of humanity. فَهَذَا مِنْهَاجُ رِيَاضُ الْمُرِيدِ وَتَرْبِيَتِهِ فِي التَّدْرِيجِ إِلَىٰ لِقَاءِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ. So this is the method of self-discipline of the murid, the disciple who is, you know, sharpening his will to subjugate his hedonistic self and desires to the will of Allah Ta'ala. وَتَرْبِيَتِهِ. And his education, فِي التَّدْرِيجِ, you know, gradual education of that murid, إِلَىٰ لِقَاءِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ, until he meets his Lord. So this is the education method. فَمَّا تَفْصِيلُ الرِّيَاضَةِ فِي كُلِّ صِفَةٍ فَسَيَأْتِي. But the detailed explanation of self-discipline with respect to every human attribute, this will follow in the next chapters. فَإِنَّ أَغْلَبَ الصِّفَاتِ عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ بَطْنُهُ وَفَرْجُهُ وَلِسَانُهُ. Because the predominant attributes of human beings, you know, is their you know, stomach, procreative, like the shahwat, the sexual desires, and also tongue. You know, so these are very powerful, predominant, you know, on human beings. أعني به الشهوات المتعلقة بها. You know, by this he says, I mean the desires, you know, emanating, originating from batn, farj, and lisan. ثم الغضب الذي هو كالجندي لحماية الشهوات. Then anger, which is like the guards for the protection of these desires. ثم مهما أحب الإنسان شهوة البطن والفرج وأنس بهما أحب الدنيا. So when one falls in love with the desires of the stomach and the sexual desires, and then he loves this world, the mundane world. وَلَمْ يَتَمَكَّ مِنْهَا إِلَّا بِالْمَالِ وَالْجَاهِ. But he cannot acquire this mundane life, this dunya, except by gaining wealth and also popularity. Al-jah, وَإِذَا طَلَبَ الْمَالَ وَالْجَاهَ But when he tries to acquire wealth and popularity, حَدَثَ فِيهِ الْكِبْرُ وَالْعُدُوُ وَالْرِيَاسَ Then he gets inflicted by the by arrogance, by hidden arrogance, and also desire for leadership. رِيَاسَ وَإِذَا ظَهَرَ ذَلِكَ When these occur, لَمْ تَسْمَحْ نَفْسُهُ بِتَرْكِ الدُّنْيَا رَأْسًا His nafs will not let him leave the mundane world easily. وَتَمَسَّكَ مِنَ الدِّينِ بِمَا فِيهِ الرِّيَاسَةُ وَغَلَبَ عَلَيْهِ الْغُرُورُ Then he will hold up to a religion in such a way that it will bring him leadership, you know, high status. وَغَلَبَ عَلَيْهِ الْغُرُورِ Self-deception will prevail over him. So he will run after riyasat, leadership, rulership, power, political power, but he will be self-eluded that you know he is running after religion. فلهذا وجب علينا بعد تقديم هذين الكتابين أن نستكمل ربع المهلكات بثمانية كتب إن شاء الله تعالى. And Imam Ghazali says that for this reason, the remaining 8 books of the quarter of Muhlikat, is in the following order. كتاب في كسر شهوة البطن والفرج, one chapter on destroying the desires, like for eating more and sexual desires. وكتاب في كسر شرح الكلام, and also another chapter on controlling the hedonistic desire to speak more. كتاب في كسر الغضب والحقد والحسد, another chapter on destroying the anger, the desire for taking revenge, and also jealousy. كتاب في ذم الدنيا وتفصيل خدعها, and another chapter on critique of the mundane world, and also the detailed explanation of the tricks of the mundane world. كتاب في كسر حب المال وذم البخل, another chapter on breaking the love of money, wealth, and also a critique of stinginess. وكتاب في ذم الرياء وحب الجاه, another chapter on critique of showing off, and also love of popularity. كتاب في ذم الكبر والعجب, another chapter on the critique of arrogance and secret arrogance. وكتاب في مواقع الغرور, and another chapter on the places where self-deception takes place. So these are the remaining 8 chapters of the book, but the ground is laid by the 2 chapters in the beginning. So the following 8 books, they are kind of commentaries and detailed explanations of what's mentioned in the first 2 chapters. وبذكر هذه المهلكات وتعليم طريق المعالجة فيها يتم غرضنا من ربع المهلكات إن شاء الله تعالى. And by explaining these causes of destruction and teaching the methods of treating them, curing them, our purpose will be achieved in the quarter of Al-Muhlikat. فإنما ذكرناه في الكتاب الأول هو شرح لصفات القلب الذي هو معدن المهلكات والمنجيات. وما ذكرناه في الكتاب الثاني هو إشارة كلية إلى طريق تهذيب الأخلاق ومعالجة أمراض القلوب. أما تفصيلها فإنه يأتي في هذه الكتب إن شاء الله تعالى. فإن ما ذكرناه يعني في الكتاب الأول. So he says that what we mentioned in the first chapter هو شرح لصفات القلب. It is an explanation of the attributes of the heart. الذي هو معدن المهلكات والمنجيات. Which is the center of the causes of destruction and the causes of salvation. So the heart is the center of causes of destruction, al-muhlikat wal-munjiyat. So, and this is explained in the book on the heart and the attributes of the heart. وَمَا ذَكَرْنَاهُ فِي الْكِتَابِ الثَّانِي. And what we mentioned in the second book, which is this book that we have just, finishing, we will just finish now. هو إشارة كلية. It's a general, explanation. إلى طريق تهذيب الأخلاق ومعالجة أمراض القلوب. Ornamenting or improving your morality, and also treating illnesses of your heart. So إشارة كلية, a general explanation. أما تفصيلها, but the detailed explanation, فإن يأتوا في هذه الكتب إن شاء الله تعالى. The detailed explanation will follow in the subsequent 8 chapters. تم الكتاب رياضة النفس وتهذيب الخلق ومعالجة أمراض القلب, وهو الكتاب الثاني من ربع المهلكات من كتب إحياء علوم الدين. بحمد الله وعمله, وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وسلم تسليما. يتلوه كتاب كسر الشهوتين. الحمد لله, we finished that book, that chapter today, and next week inshallah we'll continue with book on sabr and shukr inshallah ta'ala. والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. Yes, do you have any questions?
Yes, Hocam, I just wanted to clarify something. So there are 10 books, right?
Yes, 10 books, two of them, we read two of them.
Yes. And
there is, eight remaining books.
Okay, so what was the sixth one?
It is in the list. You can have a look at it in the list. Let me see. Okay. So, so Dhanbu Dunya wa Tafsilu Khuda'iha, critique of the mundane life and the detailed explanation of its tricks. That's the sixth one. Yes.
Okay.
Is there another question?
Thank you so much. No, thank you.
Okay. Inshallah ta'ala. May Allah keep you in good health. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam, Hocam. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.